I'm entitling this message, "What Do You Do With a Gift?" Okay. God saves us freely by His grace. We are saved by faith, or by grace through faith, and it is not of ourselves. It is the gift of God. And what do we do to receive this gift? Well, what we do is we believe 1 Corinthians 15. I'm going to read 3 through 4, but I think it should be believe it all. But 3 through 4 states that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. When we believe that, truly believe that with our heart, and we understand that we are sinners, and that there is only one way to the Father in heaven, and that is by the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the only way. So we need to understand that we are sinners, because all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So we acknowledge in our hearts, yes, we are sinners. And yes, we know that Jesus is the only way to the Father. And yes, we know that all our works are as filthy rags before God. We have no righteousness of ourselves. We cannot earn our way into heaven, no matter how good we are, no matter how kind and generous we are, no matter how morally upright we are. We are born with sin. We are born with a nature of sin. It's in our flesh. It's been handed down to us from Adam, and there is nothing we can do apart from Jesus to be found worthy to enter into God's presence and into His kingdom. So we understand that. We acknowledge that in our heart, and we reach out to God for His gift of salvation, of a new spirit. When we believe that Jesus died for us, for our sins, so that we could have a way to the Father, when we truly believe that, and we believe that God raised him from the dead, that is, he raised Jesus from the dead so that we could be justified. That means completely exonerated. That means completely all the justice was satisfied through the blood of Christ. His blood makes it possible for us to be cleansed and to be made righteous in God's sight. There is nothing we can do of our own to make ourselves righteous in God's sight. Once we believe this in our hearts, that is the repentance that God is seeking. It's not turning from your sin. How do you turn from your sin? It's already done. It's already committed. The death of Jesus, the blood of Christ, paid our sin debt, all of it, past, present, and future. So when we believe in our heart and understand in our minds that of ourselves we are nothing before God, no matter how good we are, no matter how kind we are, nothing. And it doesn't matter how great a sinner we have been. Once we accept this gift from God by believing on His Son, we are sealed with the Holy Spirit. Our dead spirits are made new, quickened to life. We are then given the power to overcome our flesh in the future. Our walk with Christ doesn't start until we are sealed with His Holy Spirit, until we are saved in God's sight. Then the performance, and it's not really performance, it's letting go of self, and it's saying, God, I want to live according to Your will. That's when the change starts to take place. And it doesn't happen overnight. Some may experience some changes immediately. And I'm not talking about fleshly changes like modern day Christianity or churchianity has made it sound, like you need to quit smoking. Like, I don't find that a sin anywhere in the Bible, and I don't smoke. But I do use an electronic cigarette, so, and some of these self-righteous people would probably consider this a sin. But see, I know it's not. So, let's get past that. I'm sorry, I digress. We are given the power to change, to let go of what we want, to let go of the fleshly desires that we've had through the sin nature. And we are given the power to start walking in the Spirit, and that is looking after the things of God. And our guidebook is the Bible, and specifically, it's the epistles of Paul. It's Romans through Philemon that are the doctrine we are to follow. That's the doctrine by which our minds are renewed, because we are made new creatures in Christ. When we believe the gospel and we acknowledge that we need the Savior, the only Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Romans 3:23-28. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God hath set forth to be a propitiation, that's complete satisfaction, through faith in His blood, to declare His righteousness, that's God's righteousness, for the remission of sins that are past, through the forbearance of God, to declare, I say, at this time, His righteousness, that He might be just, and the justifier of him which believeth in Jesus. Where is boasting then? It is excluded. By what law? Of works? Nay, by the law of faith. Therefore, we conclude that a man is justified by faith without the deeds of the law. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Okay, let this sink into your heart. 2 Corinthians 5:19 through 20, to wit, that God was in Christ, reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and hath committed unto us the word of reconciliation. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead, be ye reconciled to God. For he hath made him, that is Christ Jesus, to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Amen. So what do you do with a gift? You stretch forth your hand, or in this case, your heart, and you receive it. And you say, thank you, Father. Thank you for this great salvation. Thank you for this gift of eternal life with you and the Lord Jesus Christ and all the saints and angels in your kingdom forever and ever. To you be the glory, the honor, and the praise. Just thank you, thank you, thank you. And you receive that gift into your heart. Oh, glory to God. Much love to you all in Christ Jesus, our Lord. May the peace of the Lord be with you all. Amen.